Hey everybody, and welcome back to the Dark Souls 2 playthrough. My name is James, also known as Bish, and welcome to episode 10 of the Dark Souls 2 playthrough. So where were we last time? We had killed the smelter demon with some help from a couple of co-op friends. We also tried to take on the pursuer and got killed. We got ambushed. So we're gonna go do that first. We're gonna take on that first quickly before I do go and take him out. I would like to know. I've just done a couple of things off screen, just to get prepared for this. I bought some iron arrows and some wooden arrows. I've also bought some wooden bolts and some heavy bolts. I've also upgraded the bastard sword up to level 3 and the Dragonlake sword up to level 1. Dragonlake sword uses a tweaking twilight knight. And the Bastard Sword uses obviously the usual Titanite shards. So I've just done those two. I wanted to upgrade a couple of weapons, and I thought that those two were, you know, I'm feeling those weapons this playthrough. So we're gonna go through the rest of this episode with the Bastard Sword, I think. Especially considering that this area is the fire redundant, so. We shouldn't be using fire weapons, so we're going to use a bastard sword. And finally, just to finish off, also I've upgraded my strength for 6 levels. So it was 24, and I've upgraded it to 30 using the souls that we got from the smelter demon. So now that we've done that, let's go try and take out this guy down here for a second time, and hopefully we won't lure the other guy to attack us this time. Alright, let's see what we can do. Hopefully. We got some. It's all just about taking it nice and slow. I'm not going to try and hit him 3 times like last time. Sometimes it's probably best just not to do anything to him at all, because, well, you don't really want to be getting hit, do you? Let's face it. We're only going to take it nice and slow. I don't want to get pinned to the wall. That is the only thing, is if I get pinned to the wall, then I'm going to die, probably. If I go too far into the middle of the room, I'm going to pull that guy again. So I don't want to do that. I could have just gone around and killed the other guy, but I make things hard for myself. Because I'm silly. It's all good though. Oh, I got hit there because I dodged too quickly. I'm only going to hit him once there. I'm going to heal here. I've done it again. Always dodge that third move, because most of the time it homes onto you. It's kind of weird. This game has got some really weird, like, homing mechanics with the AI on the enemy AI. It's a bit annoying, actually, because stuff like backstabs become a lot harder. Ooh, we've staggered him, so we've got an extra hit in there. That is a move that I always seem to forget about. That combo that he does there is a bit of a strange one. Right, come on, do something silly so that I can. Ooh, that was low. That was really close. Okay. So that move, you don't even have to dodge, because it's kind of a just one of those moves. As long as you go to the right, you should be completely fine. I know this is a bit of a boring fight, but it is still a. A fight nonetheless, and it's with our good old friend the pursuer, so we can't really complain. Oh, that was close. If he had done a combo, then I probably would have been in trouble. The cool thing is about that last move is that as long as you don't dodge, you also get a bit of stamina back as well, so you can go in for another attack if you need to. He actually only attacked us one there. Don't get attacked by his blue sword. I might have said this before in the old fight. Don't get attacked. There's an attack that he does that basically gives him a blue sword. Do not get attacked by that, because it will curse you. making you hollow. And it will also give him a couple of extra moves that you don't really want him using because they're quite powerful. Plus, extra moves is never a good thing because it means that you then have to anticipate what he's going to do next. The less moves he's got, the better, really. Okay, we're almost there. Let's not make any mistakes now. One more hit. Oh, two more hits. There we go. And there he is. He's been taken down. So he drops an item, which should be the Ring of Blades plus one. There it is. Excellent. So we've now got the Ring of Blades plus one, which is pretty ace, if you ask me. And that guy, we don't even need to, we didn't even pull him, so fantastic. Let's go rest at the bonfire again. Not like we really need to, but, well, actually, no saying that, that's always a good idea if we do, actually, because it replenishes our weapon durability. And we're going to open this door, and we're going to continue on with the Iron Keep, which is going to be fun. The first thing you see here is that area to the right, and then this guy here. This guy was the guy that was arching us before, and I'm going to try and backstab him, if I can actually backstab him. He keeps dodging me. This never happens. There we go. I got him. And I killed him. Wow. Nice. Alone Knight leggings. The Alone Knight captains, that's what they are, they're captains. They drop not only the... So you got these knights here, and you've got the other knights that are down there. They've both got different helmets on, and they do actually drop each other like their specific helmets. So if you want to kill the captain for their helmets, as well as the other guys, you can get both helmets, which is pretty ace. Right, this area is kind of weird. You got this guy here who comes at you, and then you got the other guy that just starts hammering the floor for no reason whatsoever. There is a reason. And that reason is he's attacking the floor below him so that I can't get across. So the only way to get across now is for me to jump across this bit here. So we actually broke that there. There was actually a platform there. But it means that now I'm gonna have to jump across. Which, if you're attacking the other guy and you want to escape, is not a good thing. It also means that on the way back, you're in a bit of a situation. That was a terrible play for me, that was. Oh, ayo. I'm trying not to go into the room too much, because I know what's in here. I'm moving around now for a reason. You'll see in just a second. You got... Ah, the other guy doesn't see... There he is. He's up there. There's usually a archer just there. He might have fallen off, actually. So the reason why I bought those arrows was really to get a bit of range in here, because this area is full of assholes that just range you from afar. Iron great arrows, can't really complain there. This switch, for those of you that don't know, or if everybody's just really curious, see those two guys there just sitting there? This is like FromSoft's way of saying you guys control too. Just drops them into the lava, which is just, oh, I love it. It's fantastic. However, that does then bring these fire... what's its face is down. If you then press the switch again, it'll bring that back up again, and you'll be able to just do this area without the fire. But the thing with this being up like this, it means you'll be able to get to that ladder there. If you've pulled it back down again, like I just said, then you won't be able to get up to that ladder, I don't think, if I remember rightly. Right, so if we go through this door, there is a Ferris Lockstone receptacle. And if we put our Ferris Lockstone in here, we get a nice ladder up to this area. This area. That's all I'm going to say. I hate it. When you get on to the second playthrough, this area is it's like a PvP central sort of place. However, it's not one of those PvP areas where you get to choose who comes into your world. It's not that, unfortunately. It's completely different. You've got a random people just start attacking you from up here. Up here is the Covenant to I think we've met this guy once already, possibly, unless I may have skipped him, I'm not too sure. But this guy here will allow us to join a continent, but I'm not going to join it because it's part of. I want to be part of the Sombros, so.
Undead! Keep your heads up, our bell! The great bell of Ven! The bell belongs to the prince, you do!
Such a strange character.
Stay back or we slice you to bits. Me and my chums, we shan't be miffed. Stay back or your pieces, tiniest pieces.
The voice acting on this is just absolutely fantastic.
A long, long, long time ago, the prince he made me, yes, just like so. Princess's honor. Stay away, foul undead, or you'll be a goner. Stay back. It belongs to the prince. Yes, it do.
It's fantastic. It's absolutely fantastic.
You wish to guard the bell, you do. For the princess and prince, forever, for true.
The answer is no, mate.
Useless fool, filthy undead. Be gone right now, or it's off with your head.
Well, there you go. See you later then. Wow. Some people these days. I forgot how ridiculous these were. Ooh. I have no idea what happened then. I swear he hit me with a... Try not to get hit by these little guys. They might look... like, they're just nothing, but they are really powerful. Oh! Oh my god, that was way too close. As was that. Right then, that was... Yeah, look at my health then, did you see that? Might as well use one of these. So we've got another one down here, but it's a little bit different. He's a great sword, I think. He's a great sword wielder. I don't know whether you can backstab these guys. I actually think you can, but it's very difficult to. Ah, this is the problem. This is the exact reason why I hate this place. So I've just been invaded by somebody else online. Another human player. This is going to make this interesting. The only problem is... I've still got this guy to take out. So we're just going to range him and hope... that the other guy doesn't come after us while we're doing this. I don't know where he is. Probably waiting for me to come up the bell tower. Which is usually what they do. Whoa. Whoa. Well, we didn't even get a chance to be attacked by the invader because we got killed by that guy. It's been a while. It has been a while. Jump cut. Okay, guys, welcome back. So, I'm back here again now. I've got my souls. And this time we're not being invaded by someone. So, hopefully, we should be able to kill this guy without problems, hopefully. Only problem with this guy is he doesn't stagger easy as well. So, becomes quite the problem. Cheese him out, why not? It's the best way forward. It is the best way forward. If you ever want to play Dark Souls, the original Dark Souls, best way forward. Just cheese it. Just cheese it all the way. That game gave me so much troubles. Very, very difficult game. So we ring the bell tower. Also inside this corner is a simpleton spice. Very, very nice. And up here is probably where that guy that invaded us was going to be. The reason why is because of that guy over there. Usually, they sort of, the guys that invade online, they use this guy as an extra helping hand because he's a ranger. And it's a bit of an unfair play, really. The reason why I really don't like this place is, see, now usually I would be like, okay, fair enough, a PvP, fair fight, not too bad. But the reason why I actually really don't like this place is you can be invaded by up to 3 other players. That isn't nice at all. Especially when you don't even get a choice in the matter. You literally do not get a choice in the matter. You rather, you get invaded by these guys while you're doing your playthrough without even realizing. Sometimes, you might not really be paying much attention, and I'm going to get invaded again. So this guy is being an asshole. This guy, I don't know what he's doing. He's probably waiting for me to get killed by these guys, probably. Using soul arrow. And now he's being impatient and coming up. Wow, lag. Wow, nice. Dude, get away from me. And now being invaded by that other guy. This is the reason why I absolutely hate this location. he's running for it. And that's it. I've stopped them from killing me. Wow, that was really lucky. And it was also a bit of a wimp move, really. But they shouldn't have invaded me. So there you go. Shouldn't have invaded me. I've come back up here to grab this chest because I want to see what it is. I've forgotten. It's been a long time since I played this game properly. So, immolation. What does immolation do? Let's have a look. I think it says immolation. Oh, it is the pyromancy that basically coats you in fire. But it also is really, really devastating if someone else hits you with it. So basically, it kills you, and it's almost like a self-sacrifice. It's killing you, but it also kills the opponent. It's really strange. It's a really strange pyromancy. And one that I must admit, I've never really used because it just seems so pointless. Here is a hidden room with, if I remember rightly, some sort of Black Knight weapon. Yes, the Black Knight Greatsword. We might use that for this playthrough actually later on, because we are a strength build after all. Something like that might be nice. The Grand Spirit Tree Shield and the Protective Chime, just to add to it as well. I don't really want to rest there, because we'd have to go do all that again. That's the only reason why I don't like that bonfire. Let's see. I haven't even got any healing items, really. The only ones I've really got are these cure, which usually take a lot longer to heal you, if I remember rightly. I'm going to use a Divine Blessing. Screw it. I never use these anyway. It's very rarely that I'll ever use these. Okay, let's clear this room out of guards. Otherwise, we're going to have some problems. That's one guy down. Okay, this guy can't hit us, luckily. I might just quickly do a transition with this one, or just speed it up, because this is quite an annoying process. Okay. All right then. So, how I'm gonna handle this next area? I'm going to pull down this lever, which will bring that down and kill those. Now, there's two archers on either side of this area here. However, very nicely placed are, oh, up close, are these little pads here I just hit him down. You can do this with this guy as well. Be very careful not to fall off yourself, but yeah, you can do it that way. And up these stairs, like I said, if you'd press that switch again, or you just generally didn't press it in the first place, you wouldn't be able to get up here. This, I almost fell for it then, actually, almost fell for it, is the very first metal mimic in the game. You have no idea. Oh, seriously. Me and my friend were joking about that. We were joking, oh, could you imagine if this metal chest was a mimic? And I opened it. The one time that we say, oh, it might be a mimic, you know. Could you imagine if it was a mimic? Like, it'd be really funny. And then it just happened. Never again. Destructive Great Arrows as well there. This area up here is actually optional. But I sort of want to show it, so we're going to do it. Inside that receptacle, you can get some healing water again. We don't really need it. Okay, so inside this room, yeah, I thought so, are three archers, not two. There's quite a few. We've run out of. Actually, let's swap this over to our heavy crossbow for a bit, and let's use the other crossbow bolts. It would be helpful if we could. Oh, that's better. I don't want these guys hitting us. We haven't got much health as it is. I know where the next bonfire is, and it's relative. Well, it's not relatively far away, but it's far enough for us to get hurt and killed if we're not careful. So, when I get to the next bonfire, that will be probably the end of this episode. I want to make this a little bit shorter. Not too much shorter, but just a little bit shorter, because it's a nightmare. It takes ages. These take ages to render, which is, you know, it doesn't bother me too much, but my computer has, you know, can't, my computer can't cope with everything, so, and maybe until next month when I get a few more things for it, but until then, my computer is still quite underpowered. Anyway, we got one more guy, so we'll just take this guy out from Melly, and he was trying to kill us, and failed epically. Look at that. He's down. Inside this chest, and brightly, is another Black Knight weapon, actually, and I think it's a Black Knight Great Axe? Yes, it was. It was a Great Axe, yeah. That was a really good guess, actually. That was the helmet. That's the captain's helmet that I just got there. It's picked up so that you can see. So that one's the Alone Captain helmet, the captain one. And you can also get the Alone helms, which the normal ones use. Put our normal helmet back on. What did we just get? We got the Great Axe, didn't we? So that's the Great Sword, which we can yet wield properly. It's got a really kind of nice moveset. That is the R2. That's the R1. We've got like a horizontal sort of swing. And down here is the Black Knight Great Axe. This weapon is mental. Look at this. Obviously, it's slow because I haven't got the stats for it right now. But eventually, it will be quite powerful. All weapons that are tempting to use throughout this playthrough. I don't know whether I need the Cat's Ring for this next area. I don't think I do, but we'll find out very shortly. So we jump down these slowly, make sure we don't fall off. Crap, red eye orb and torch, nothing special really. So we jump onto this bit here. Luckily, on this bit, we're safe, there's nobody here. You would think that it's not a good area to go down, but this is actually the area we've got to go down. Drop onto that. This is one of the only reasons why I don't like going this way. You've got to be very careful. Gold covenant serpent ring. I didn't know that even was there, actually. And we can take this guy out. Luckily, we've got a good enough weapon to be able to do that. Through that fog, by the way, is just where we were in that last room a minute ago. This is the opposite way of coming into this next area. I won't go through the fog gate, but yeah, that's the other way to go, and it's the easier way to go, much easier. The only reason why you would want to go this way that I've just gone is to get the Great Axe. These guys have got really easy moves. Apart from that one. That is the only move that puts you off. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, dear. I thought because he was going back on himself that he was going to leave us. Come on. Right, okay. There we go. Usually what I do is I take one hit. Ah, that move. That move. That move too, apparently. I'm getting killed by this thing really badly. That was a really silly move. Let's just keep away from him. There we go. Use another healing move, another healing potion. Finally kill him. Right, okay. I've never actually had that much problem with that guy. He's usually a lot easier than that. But as I was going to say, the best way to fight him is just to bait his move, wait for him to do it, and then attack him once and dodge back. This next area, that guy there, first time, had me. He actually did have me. Oh yes, I was waiting for that. Yeah, you can chop him in half with the guillotine, which is pretty fantastic. Okay, this next room, don't go rushing in, obviously. I'm going to be taking it nice and slow. Don't touch the spikes. Quite an obvious thing, that. I wouldn't get the that item until you come up here and stop the fire. This area up here is where we go to get to the next bonfire. We're basically safe now. Unless you're on playthrough 2 and there'd be a really, really hard phantom in this room here. We're going up these stairs. And if you remember rightly, when I first came into the Iron Keep last episode, I said that we were going to go inside the ox's head. Well, that's actually where we are right now. We are inside the ox's head. These are the eyes, just here. We got that one there, and this one over here, and that there is where is it Marigold? I can't remember his name now. That salesman down there is. So we press this lever, it will stop most of the fire, which is really nice. I think actually all of the fire, actually. And it will turn off some of the traps and stuff. Okay, now that we've got... I'm gonna make this an episode, guys, because... No, sorry, I'm gonna fight the boss before I make the end of this episode, because... We're very close, and we've almost done the Iron Keep. I thought, why not do it? Get it over and done with now, and we'll get on to the next area. Come on, guy. Just take this nice and slow. Leave him. Screw you, mate. Don't need you anymore. Okay, so down here is the boss room. This guy won't follow you all the way. He'll follow you to probably about here, I think. Here is about the boundaries that he can go. And inside this room is the boss fight. Now, see if we can maybe get a couple people to join us, maybe. That'd be quite nice. If not, then we are alone. But that's fine. Okay, turns out it gets a little bit closer than I expected, but yeah, that's about right anyway. That's about where we're up to, where he can go, and then he'll just go back on himself. Okay. Let's see. We'll use lightning for this one, I think. Should we just go in? Let's do it. We've got ourselves a bonfire. If we die, then we're close. So let's fight this guy. This guy reminds me of can't remember his name now, but Lord of the Rings. I can't remember the monster. I'll put it on the screen. there's a monster in Lord of the Rings that just reminds me of that so badly. This boss is uber cool. Absolutely love this boss to bits. He's really, really awesome. This boss has got some pretty hard moves. Luckily, because we're on single player on this boss, his health hasn't been increased, so it shouldn't be too bad. Hopefully. That's if I don't get killed by one of his silly moves. Just dodge to whatever way he moves his hand. Just... well, swings his hand. Oh! Ah! Okay. I thought I was going to get that in the first time. First try. Unbelievable. Okay. Well, let's try again. And this time, it's going to happen. We're going to do it. And I reckon probably I might just do it without co-op. But if there is another guy that wants to do co-op with us, I will do it. Because it's good fun. Co-op is always good fun. I think that I said somewhere. somewhere in the playthrough that I wasn't going to do co-op. But I've changed my mind. I have changed my mind. And that's it. That's how it goes, unfortunately. I like to change my mind. 73. Why is... Oh, it's because of the heavy crossbow. That's why. Might as well put the lightning bow on, actually. So you got two magic ones. We'll use the magic ones. Now, when you go into this boss room the second time, he will come up from a different area. This time, he actually comes up through... Let's just quickly go grab this. On the left-hand side there, and he also spurts out fire, so we'd be very careful. Seems as though the... seems as though this magic does a hell of a lot better. Right, let's try not to get hit by these this time. You can dodge through these. Uh-oh, this is a bad move. Luckily, we can punish him for it. Ow. That was accidental. Let's heal. Luckily, this guy has some moves that just... can be blocked and dodged very, very easily. Apart from that one. Oh, that was close. We're in a really, really silly position right now. And I think that's just killed me. Oh my god, I actually haven't died. He did it the opposite way around. I've never seen him do it the opposite way around there. That was lucky. I'm being very, very careless. It's been so long since I've done these boss fights. It just feels so strange playing them again. That was lucky as well. Okay, come on. How did that even happen? Right, I clearly can't do this. So, we will do this next time. Thank you for watching, guys, and we'll see you again very soon. Bye-bye.